boys and girls, I hope that you're having a great morning. Just want you to know that I love you and I miss seeing each of your bright and smiling faces each morning. But we will get through this and we will be together when school starts in the fall. This week we are reading I Am Spring by Rebecca and James McDonald. When the day becomes longer than the night and the leaves begin to sprout on the bare branches and bugs and animals that were hiding start to reappear, get ready because that means spring is here. I really enjoyed this book yesterday, boys and girls. I hope you did. We're going to read it again today and talk some more about the pictures in the book. One way that people can tell it's the first day of spring is the light of day lasts as long as the dark of night. This is called the spring equinox. So the first day of spring is called the spring equinox. Daytime and nighttime last the same amount of time. During spring, each day, the sun rises a little earlier and sets a little later in the afternoon, making days longer and brighter. Tell me what you see in those pictures, boys and girls. Can you tell me what you see? Oh, come on. I know you aren't quite awake yet, but tell me what you see in those pictures. I see deer, and I see geese. In the sky. Do you see the deer and geese? I thought you did. Brighter weather means the dirt is warmer, so seeds sprout and push their way up toward the sun. See how the plants are starting to come up out of the ground, boys and girls. As the weather gets warmer, the plants grow. You remember yesterday I showed you how the plants were growing in the seeds that we planted a couple of weeks ago, the sunflower seeds and the tomato seeds. So in a little while, I'll be able to replant those into containers and into my flowers. Spring is one of the growing seasons when seeds grow and vegetables that can be picked and eaten. This is a picture of a farm, boys and girls. You see the barn back here? What's sitting in front of the barn? That's right, it's a tractor, and you use a tractor on a farm to plow the ground, cut the hay. Tractors have a lot of uses on a farm. And look here, boys and girls, you see this right here? These plants right here? That looks like pumpkins to me. And in the fall, pumpkins will grow over the summer. And in the fall, pumpkins turn orange. And look, boys and girls, that looks like tomato plants with tomatoes on them. High up in the sky, when warm spring air mixes with cold ocean air, it can cause bursts of rain showers, watering the land and helping things to grow. Do you see the rain in the pictures? The child here has their rain boots on, a raincoat, and an umbrella. And what's up in the top of the picture up here? Can you tell me what that is, boys and girls? That's right, it's a rainbow. I love to see rainbows, don't you? You see rainbows whenever, usually after there's been a shower of rain. Bees and other insects come out of hiding and visit flowers for a sip of sweet nectar and a bit of pollen. Look at all the honeybees and boys and girls. You see those bees? And they're coming to the flowers, and they're getting nectar, and they're getting pollen to take back to their beehives to make honey. Many birds that flew away to avoid the cold winter return to the warm sunshine of spring skies. When birds travel to far off places for better weather and more food, scientists call this migration. So, in the fall, a lot of birds will migrate or fly to a warmer climate for the wintertime because they don't like cold weather, so they want to go somewhere where it is warm. And a lot of times they fly south to Georgia and Florida and Alabama, Louisiana, Texas. They fly south to go to warmer weather. And we call that migration, guys. As spring warms the land, the sound of birdsong fills the air. Birds chirp, tweet, and trill, calling out to meet one another and to claim the areas that they want to live in. You see the birds sitting up here on the branch? And you see the notes coming out of the bird's mouth? That means that the bird is singing. Listen, can you hear the birds here? Well, I hear a blue jay. I have a lot of blue jays around my house. And every once in a while, I'll hear a crow. And then there's some songbirds, too, boys and girls, around my house. Did you hear that? That was a songbird. Spring is also the time for building nests and laying eggs. So look here. See, this is a mama cardinal, and she has made her nest. Her nest down here is made out of straw and sticks, and she's woven it together to make a safe place to lay her. That's right, there's two eggs in that nest. While birds up high, frogs and toads are down low, laying eggs in ponds, under leaf, and sometimes even carrying eggs around on their backs. There's plenty to eat in the warmth of spring. So, the birds are up in the air flying around, and we have the frogs and toads down on the ground. Can you see that, boys and girls? And they lay their eggs in the water. Sometimes they carry their eggs on their back. Can you see that right there? And there's always a lot of insects that the frogs and toads can eat. And you can see that over here. Look how far out that frog's tongue came to get that insect. Spring sunshine and the smell of growing food wake up sleepy animals that rest during the cold months. What animal is this, boys and girls? Can you tell me what animal you see right there? That's right, it's a bear. And over here is the cave that the bear has slept in all winter. And we call that hibernation. In the fall, a lot of animals hibernate. Bears go into caves, groundhogs go deep into the ground, into their dens. And they stay there until it gets warm again, and then they come out. While the warm sun and with the warm sun and lots of food, spring is a perfect season for babies to grow. Look, boys and girls, what kind of animal is this over here? Can you tell me what kind of animal that is? That's right, it's a skunk. How many of you have ever smelled a skunk? I definitely And when you smell a skunk, that usually means that something has scared them and they have sprayed their sweet aroma to scare off whatever has scared them. And look, how many baby skunks do we see here? Let's count. 1, 2, 3. I see a mama skunk and 3 baby skunks. Bare branches on trees begin to sprout new leaves, and some will also grow blossoms. Blossom is another way of saying flowers. You see all the flowers in the tree, the blossoms in these trees over here, boys and girls. And guys, look, there's animals over here at the pond. What kind of animals are those? Can you tell me? That's right, it's raccoons. You know, boys and girls, I have raccoons that come to my house almost every night. They come up on my back porch and they eat the cat food that's left over that Bass doesn't eat during the day. Let's count and see how many raccoons there are. 1, 2, 3. I see 3 raccoons. And guys, look, if you look down in here in the water, can you see that? You can see the reflection of the raccoons. Isn't that neat? I love to go to a lake and stand, or a creek, and stand and look in and see my reflection in the water. A gentle spring breeze moving through blooming branches can make it feel like it's raining flowers. You know, in the springtime, boys and girls, there's a lot of trees that bloom. They have blossoms on them. And when a breeze comes through and the limbs in the tree start waving in the breeze, moving in the breeze, the flowers just fall off of the trees. And it's kind of like it's raining flowers, isn't it, boys and girls? Plants like trees are very helpful with keeping the air clean. They remove pollution through their leaves and catch dust and other floating particles on their branches and bark. With all the new growth in spring, there are lots of plants to clean the air. This is a picture of a park in a big city, boys and girls. A lot of times, if you live in a big city, you don't get to see the beauty of nature that we have around us, boys and girls. So the cities have parks, areas where there's trees and flowers, and there's paths that you can walk in so that people can get out and enjoy some of Mother Nature. And all of the plants and trees help with the pollution, boys and girls. One way that people help to keep their air clean is by planting new trees and taking care of plants that are already here. So in the spring, people will plant new trees in their yard. Sometimes the trees grow up to be really big. Sometimes they stay small. And then you also take care of the plants that are in your flower beds, that are in your gardens. You take care of those and help them grow because they help you. When the day becomes longer than the night and the leaves begin to sprout on the bare branches and bugs and animals that were hiding start to reappear, get ready, because that means spring is here. We have ducks. There's baby ducks there, boys and girls. Look at all the flowers. So when the days become longer than the night, and you see the leaves and the flowers and the animals come out of their hiding places, then that means that spring is here. Guys, I hope you've enjoyed our book this morning. I've enjoyed sharing it with you. Just remember, Miss Grace loves you. I miss you. And I'll see you tomorrow. Bye, guys.